There's nothing more emotionally painful than being in love with someone who doesn't seem to care about you back. So how do you know if you're more in love with him than he is with you? I have five signs that I'm going to be going over today. Hello, my name is Matthew Coast, and welcome to Commitment Connection. All right, so what are the five signs? Let's go over them here. Number one. He doesn't seem to care about your time, effort, or attention. So your time, effort, and attention are really some of the most precious things that you have. And so when a guy takes those things for granted, he's taking you for granted, and it shows his lack of desire for you. It shouldn't be this way, right? You should be with someone who really values you, treats you as a priority, and appreciates any effort and energy that you put into the relationship. Sign number two is he is emotionally and physically absent when you need him. So one of the most important things in relationships, and one of the reasons why we get into them, is because relationships in a large part are about being there for one another when you really need each other. And it's about having someone's back that you can really count on and rely on, someone who has your back. It is possible that he's just too socially inept or has some kind of mental illness that makes him not able to recognize the importance of you being there, but it's just more likely that he just doesn't have the same love for you that you have for him. You should have someone who has your back when you need him. That's very important. Number three, he never accepts blame or responsibility. So when a man doesn't accept responsibility for things in the relationship, there's usually one of two reasons for why this happened. The first one is that he's immature. And the second one is that he's not really that into you and he's immature. You don't want to be with someone who doesn't take ownership and responsibility over their part of the relationship. That's baseline. That's like the baseline level of what you need in a healthy relationship. Ideally, you'll be in a relationship where you both take 100% responsibility over taking care of each other's needs. If he can't even take responsibility over himself, you're far away from that. Either way, you should be with someone who at the very least takes responsibility for himself and ideally takes responsibility for the entire relationship. If not, this will come back and it will be painful when things get tough in the relationship, and things always do get tough in every relationship. So number four is you always have to initiate and extend the conversation. So he rarely or almost never reaches out. If he's not at least trying to chase, pursue, and invest in you even a little bit, he's probably just not that into you. It is possible that he has some emergencies come up or some kind of secondary priorities that come up that pushed you into a secondary priority. But if this happens over a long period of time, it can really become a serious problem. And either way, you deserve a man who initiates, extends, and pursues contact and communication with you. So number five is he doesn't share or discuss anything about life. So how often does he try to bond with you? If he doesn't, it's possible that he may not trust you or feel safe with you. So what you want to do is kind of look at a contrast here to try to determine whether it's that he doesn't feel like he trusts you and that he doesn't feel safe around you, or whether it's really just that he's not that into you anymore. And the way that you do that is by looking at, does he have more enthusiasm when it comes to coworkers and friends and other women in his life? So if he does, it's more likely that he just isn't really in love with you. So either way, you should have a man who pursues bonding and connection with you, even if it's in little subtle ways. As a lot of women know, sometimes men aren't quite as expressive as a lot of women are. Sometimes it's in reverse. It kind of depends on the people you're with, right? There's It's one of those things where a lot of times women will come to me and they're like, oh, well, my guy's this way or my guy's that way. And it's different than what I'm talking about. And you have to remember that this only ever applies, like anything that you can slot somebody into, a stereotype or something, like man or women, at most, it only applies to like 80% of the population. And you know, there's always variables and fluctuations in how somebody is and who somebody is. And so you just have to remember that. So too many people suggest that that you should leave someone when the slightest thing goes wrong or something's not working. We see it in the community all the time. Women are like, just leave them, you know, get away, you know, you don't deserve that. Get away from them, right? And I'm not a big believer in that. I'm not a just dump somebody and run off kind of a person. That's not my belief system. I believe that you can heal things. I believe you can make things better. I believe that you can have a real connection with somebody if that person is also committed and interested in making that work. If you're the only person who's trying to make it work, it can be a serious problem. But if you're both actually committed to it and you work on it, then you can make things work in almost any situation. A lot of times things just came up or you created negative anchors around each other or whatever, and you have to heal those or change those or fix those, and then you can create a completely new type of relationship or kind of rebuild the spark that you used to have in the relationship. So you can grow and build a stronger bond if you want to do that. And so, you know, my suggestion is that you work on communication, right? You develop your communication, you communicate with him, you talk to him around it, you build conversation around the topic so that you can figure out where he is and what page he's on. A lot of times women act like they're like private detectives or something, you know, running around like looking for clues. It's like, oh, I found this clue and I found that clue and I found this clue. And the best clue that you can find is actually having a conversation with a guy and finding out exactly what's going on with him, because he's really the only person that can actually tell you what's going on with him. We can make speculations, we can talk about different signs, we can give you advice about different things to find out different stuff, but the best thing that you can do is have a conversation with him. And if you're afraid of having a conversation with him, that's a problem as well, and you need to figure out whether that's because of lack of confidence that's going on with you, or whether it's because of something that's going on with him, and then work to resolve that issue. So another thing that could be going on is it could be that you're not speaking the same love language. And one of the things that I talk about in I actually just created this long distance relationship program. I haven't launched it yet, but we will be launching it soon. One of the things that I talk about in there is this idea of going deeper than love languages, because love languages are great, right? The 5 Love Languages book, it's an awesome book, totally recommend it. Everyone should get a copy of it. However, there's something that goes even deeper than that, and it's, in my opinion, it's actually having a conversation with somebody about what is, you know, what makes them feel loved. And that way it's not like, I mean, it's good to have kind of these categories because then you can figure out what's going on with somebody. However, it's better to actually ask them how they feel loved. That way you can learn about them as an individual and work with them in that specific way. It also could just be that he's not feeling connected anymore, or that he's not really getting his needs met, which is something that you can definitely work on.